Okay, we are talking about the harnessation unit. So we have enterprise harnessation units across all the SAP modules. For example, if my material management guy is speaking, he will talk in terms of Hello. Yeah. And now it's better. I think some problem with the Preeti's contesting. She hadn't screen connected. Hello. Is it clear, Preeti, now? Yeah. No. Not necessary. You are in the meeting already. So nice. No, and okay, now it's in SAP screen. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Okay, we are talking about the organization unit. So, since SAP is across various modules, each module will be having their own organization unit. For example, metals management people, their main concern is about procuring goods, that is purchasing from vendors. So, they will be talking about purchasing organizations. So, they will be talking about purchasing groups. And they will be talking about the receiving plant. Okay. If some production people is speaking, they are talking, they will be talking about production plant, assets and other things. Similarly, but everything will be in SAP. So we are going to see only the organization units that are relevant for us. I mean relevant for only SD. Okay, like, yeah. Okay. Code for China will be different, code for India will be different. Once again, that is the call that has to be taken by your company. So there is no hard and fast rule, like the naming convention must be like that. So it depends on your, how you want to carry out. Yeah. Yeah, it will remain the same. Yeah. Okay. So we are going to see some of the organization units that are relevant for only SAP and SAP SD. Okay. So to carry out the sales, what are the things we will need? You will need a company, sales organization, or your company in layman language, from which you are going to sell the goods or services to your customer. And then you will be having a headquarters or some financial organization who is going to perform the analysis analyze the performance of your company in terms of financial terms. For example, like they will be writing the balance sheets, so they will be maintaining the ledger accounts. So those kind of things are there. So we have one sales unit which is taking care of the actual sales. And we have one unit which is taking care of the financial performances. Okay. So you said that you have a company, then you will be having branches. You can have branches, then you can have the sales officers, then you can have the sales personnel groups assigned to your sales office. You can assign the sales office to your certain certain geographical area. So these are all the some of the organization units. So you see those units. Can you see this screen? My screen? Okay. Sales and distribution structures of IDAS. So, what are things you can see? Here there is something called as company. Here in SAP, company is nothing but your financial performance analyst. So, this is called as company code in our normal language. I mean, normal SAP language, we say it as company code. Company code is purely a financial entity, and company code has nothing to do with your daily sales. Company code just analyzes, or it just takes care of your financial part of your transaction, which means if you carry out a transaction, what will be the normal cycle? You will create a sales order, then you will create a delivery for that, and once you have delivered that sales order, then you will be invoicing it. Once invoicing means billing, you will bill it. So once you bill it, the bill amount is not going to be posted in a single account. For example, if I say that my bill value is $100, there is not like that $100 is going to be put in single account. That $100 will be having certain components. For example, let me say $70 is your revenue, and $10 is your freight, and $20 is your tax. So the system will split that 100 into 70 plus 10 plus 20, and 70 will be posted in the domestic revenue, and 10 will be posted in the freight cost, and 20 will be posted in the tax account. So these three will be posted into three different general ledger accounts. So this maintaining of this general ledger account, creation of, one thing, just hold on.
Hello.
Yeah. Okay. So, maintaining your general ledger accounts and maintaining your balance, creating your balance sheets at the end of the year or financial quarter, whatever you are saying. So, that is always carried out by the company. Company or company code. One second, just hold on.
After 20 minutes. This is not there.
Yeah,
it's not broke. So once it last one, I will message.
Yeah, sorry for the break. So this is the company code. So company is nothing but the accounting entity, but we have to just understand what is a company code. Then comes our sales office. Sales office is the common man language. So, but in SAP we say it as sales organization. Sales organization is the entity which is taking care of your sales. In fact, it is a legal entity which is having a physical address from which you can carry out the sales activities. And since this is the place, this is a legal entity which is selling the goods or service to the customers, it is responsible for the any complaints or right of recourse from the customer. Okay. A sales organization can be assigned to only one company code. But one company code can have more than one sales organization. Can you see IDAS AG is the common company code. In fact, tomorrow when somebody is performing the analysis how IDAS is doing, they will be seeing the IDAS AG level only. But IDAS AG is having more than one sales organization. Here you can see Frankfurt and you can see something for Berlin. Okay. A company code can have more than one sales organization, but one sales organization can be assigned to only one company code. So now we have defined who is going to take care of the financial activities. Then we had also defined who is going to carry out the sales activity or who is going to sell the goods or services. Now we have to find out different ways to reach the goods to the customer. So when you buy a particular material, it's not necessary that it must come to you in only one material and one way of means, one means. Okay. For example, you can buy an article by walking into your showroom near to you. Else, you can buy a. What are the other ways of buying? Can somebody actually say? Yeah. Okay. Okay, fine. If the company policy permits, you can walk into the factory and you can take it from the factory sales outlet itself. It means direct. Okay. Preeti, you there, Preeti? Okay. I want you to respond once. Okay. Okay. Sure. So, we had told that who is going to sell. Now, we are going to see what are all the ways the goods can be sold to the customer. The means by which the goods reach the end customer. End customer is the end user basically. The means by which the goods reach the end customer is called as distribution channel. Okay. You can have more than one distribution channel. For example, if you see this picture, you can see there is a reseller and we have something called as service. We have chain stores, we have industrial customer. There are many ways of reaching the customer. So once you go for implementation and once you go for SAP implementation or rollout, you have to understand what are all the ways through which the customer, the company sells the goods to the customer. Then you have to define your distribution channels accordingly. Okay. Then now we have said, okay, who is going to sell and how we are going to sell, and the next question comes to what we are going to sell. Okay. So we will be having thousands of products, thousands and lakhs of products. Okay. But we cannot maintain them as individually. So we will be grouping those thousands and lakhs of products into some groups. So some even 100 groups or 1000 groups let it be. But we are going to group certain articles and based on certain parameters. For example, if you have the clothes, if you have clothes, not clothes, if you have the men's wear, women's wear, sports wear and everything, so these can be grouped in a single or broader entity called as clothes. You have the materials like bike, your car, your spares like lights, horns, cylinder systems, etc. You can group them in the very broad classification as automotive products. Okay. So based on some parameters, we are going to group the articles, and we call this group article group as division. Can you see the picture? In the picture, it says like there is a motorcycle. Whatever comes for the motorcycles, for example, like whether it is going to be the bike or whether it is going to be the scooter or even it is going to be the spare items like light, your spark plugs, your wires and everything, that will be taken under the motorcycle. And if your company is taking care of the service part, which is the non-tangible product, like service, you can group them under the another division called as services. So it is always better to group the products on a very broader classification while you are going to have your implementation. The reason is that you will see in the next screen. Okay. So are you now clear with the company code, sales organization, distribution channel and division? Preeti, can you just tell it in a single line? What is the company code? Okay. Okay. Then sales organization. Okay. Yeah, and there's a slight change. There's a slight change. Okay, they can be the same office or they can have more than one officer. Okay, so but this is the organization that is making sales. For example, let me say that you are buying from Pepsi US, which means you are not going to buy from the direct Pepsi US. Okay, if you have any complaints or if you want to place an order, then you need not go to the Pepsi US, that is the headquarters. Instead, you can go to any of the officers. Okay. So the sales organization and sales officers, even though like both perform the same activities, in SAP they are different entities. Yeah. Okay, then what is the distribution channel? Yeah. Yeah. And the division? Okay. Okay, fine. Abhi, you are about to ask something. Okay. Once again, depends on the organization. I mean, your business clients need. Sometimes IBM US can be a different company code, and IBM India can be a different company code, and IBM UK can be a different company code. Sometimes like it can be a single company code with IBM India as a separate sales organization. And IBM US and UK has different sales organizations. Once again, like this is the call with your end user or your client has to pay. They have to say like how they want to maintain the business. This affects when taking the balance sheet. Not in SD, it doesn't bother us in any way in SD. It is purely the accounting entity. Okay. Then in the current screen, we are seeing the sales office. The sales office is different and this is the same one. It is the sales organization. Below that, there is something called as distribution center. So, SAP, we are more concerned about production and not concerned about production. Instead, we are more concerned about reaching the goods to the customer from our warehouse. So we can have the goods in our warehouse either through production or from procurement, external procurement. So we are not pleased, we are not bothered about how the things are getting populated in our warehouse. It could be either the production department carries out the activities and finish the goods in our warehouse, or the purchasing department, they procure the goods from external vendor and fill up in our warehouse. Okay, that is their activity. So we are concerned about how we reach those goods from our warehouse to the customer. So this distribution center is called as plant. The term plant is very broad. Okay, when somebody says plant, they will think the plant is a production center. It could be a production center for production people. It could be a purchasing unit for materials management people. But when it comes to us, a plant is a delivery plant. So whenever we come across this plant hereafter in this course, it means only the delivering plant. It has nothing to do with the production. Then we have the shipping processing. Now we have got the place to store our goods. Once the customer places a sales order, this goods has to be transported to the customer. So that must start from some point. So that point from which the shipping begins to the customer is called as shipping point. From the shipping point only your delivery is taking place. Okay. So, in this thing we had seen two more units. One is the distribution center or delivery plant, then shipping processing, that is the shipping point. Okay. Yeah. It's like, yeah. Warehouse is maintained by the warehouse management. No two ways about it. But only thing, what links me to the warehouse management is like, it will say like, okay, the article is available in so and so warehouse right now. So when I make a sales order, I tell that, okay, from this warehouse you take so and so goods. That is the only link in SAP and warehouse. Okay. So now we have seen there can be only one company code, and one company code can have more than one sales organization, and one sales organization can have more than one distribution channel. And the assignment of distribution channels to sales organization is MSTN. It means the same distribution channel can be assigned to many sales organizations, and the same sales organization can have more than one distribution channel. Similarly, then we saw the plant. Plant space, like from where it is going to be delivered. So a plant is assigned to a company code directly. But in terms of sales, it is assigned to a sales organization and distribution channel. Then there is something called as storage location, which you are seeing in the current screen. Storage location, I think the name itself is self-explanatory. It just says where the goods is stored. The storage location is always found inside the delivering plant. It means if somebody writes a sales order, in the sales while creating the delivery, the system will say the article is available in the storage location 1 of the plant A. So which means, which is helpful for the picker to go and pick that. And second thing is, like when you say that it is available in that particular storage location, it is easy for carrying out the availability check. For example, if the customer is asking 100 quantities, but your system says that only 75 is available, where it is going to check? It is obviously going to check in the plant, and the where in the plant it is going to check in the storage location. So yeah, exactly. Yeah, it almost looks like okay. Then you have the shipping point. Shipping point, from where your actual delivery takes place. Once again, the assignment of shipping point is done to the plant. And the assignment is, once again, MSTN. A plant can have more than one shipping point. For example, a plant at Denver, it can send goods via road, else it can send via air, else it can send via rail. Which means, right now it has three shipping points. Whereas that particular railway station or railway point, which is serving the Denver plant, can be used by some other nearest plants also. Okay, so the assignment of plant and shipping point is MSTN. Okay, we will see those organizational units in SAP. So what is the transaction code? Preeti, can you answer what is the transaction code to go to the customizing? What? SPRO. Okay. Okay, so go to SPRO. ING. So today we are seeing about the enterprise structure. So we are not going to sales and distribution, instead we are looking out in the enterprise structures only. So click the enterprise structure. There are two parts always. One is definition and second one is assignment. Definition is mostly about how you create new organization units. For example, till now we have seen company code, sales organization, distribution channel, division, shipping point, delivering plant. Okay, so first they are not even though they are linked, when they are being created, they are creating separately. Once they are created or defined in terms of SAP language, once they are defined, it has to be assigned to the appropriate unit. For example, I define a company code first, I define a sales organization next, then I assign the sales organization to my company code. Okay, so that is what the definition and assignment mean. So go to definition. First is the financial accounting. Here you can see the company code. So company code is purely the financial accounting. So all you have to do is only just define what is a company code. Okay, so go to financial accounting, edit, copy, delete, accept company code. I click that. The system takes me to the screen. In that, okay. No, normally you don't define. Normally you don't define a company code. Company code definition will be done by the finance people. But since it just came into our copy, I'm just showing you where this company code is. Okay. So go to edit company code data. Here you can see what are all the company codes defined. For our exercises, we are going to use the company code 1000. So 1000 is the IDAS AG. It is based in Germany and the currency is Euro and the language is BE. If I click this button, it will show me the physical address of this entity. So it is saying this is the physical address. Okay, it has all the details like your store, street address, physical postal address and means of communication, numbers, who is the contact person, everything. Okay. Now I have defined the company code. So let me come to the our sales organization unit. So I close this financial account. Yeah. Here, edit, copy or delete. In that you go to the edit company code data. Yeah. I select that and I go to this links button. It gives me the details. That's it. No, I didn't make any change, so I didn't save. Okay, come back. So let us see how to create where our sales organization is located. Our sales organization is the sales unit. So I can find it under the sales and distribution node. So click there. Here you can see our sales organization which we saw now and distribution channel. Okay. So click the sales organization as usual. Go to the define sales organization. Here you can find lot of. So once again we are going to use the 1000 for our exercises. Okay. So if you want to create a sales organization for yourself, you select one line which is appropriate to you. For example, what we are using is basically the Germany client. So the setting will be like typical German. So the currency will be Euro, the company code assignment will be to the different company code which is having the Euro as their currency and their European chart of accounts, everything. If you want to create any company code which is relevant for US, then you go through the some other thing. For example, 006 is for US, 8 is also for US. Then what else is there? Scroll down. Then you have 3010. You choose any one of them, okay, and then click this button next to the new entries, which is copy as. Don't try to create a new entry by pressing new entries, because the entries will be having, I mean, like whatever entity you have, that will be having so much of back end assignments which you cannot see in the front end. So when you create a new one, you have to carry out all those back end assignments. But when you copy an existing unit and renaming it to your needs, when copying itself, the system will automatically copy the all the assignments done at the back end, so that it is easy for you. And many things, like since you don't see what are all those background assignments, whenever you are stuck with problem, then you will be spending up most of the time, not most of the time, very lot of time in fixing that. And sometimes you cannot do it because you are working alone. In case of any implementation projects or something, finance people will be there, so they will be able to help you out. So in this case, finance people will be there, basis people will be there, ADAP will be there. They will be able to help you out. But since we are working alone, we don't have any other support. So what we have to do is, we have to choose an organizational unit which is very closer to our requirements and use the copy functionality. So for example, let me create, I am going to use the organizational unit 1000 for my exercises. So I am going to copy an organizational unit 1000 and I am going to rename it. While renaming, if you are using the numbers, use the numbers that start with 9. And if you are starting with the alphabet code, start with Z or Z. Only 9 and Z says that this is a customized organization. Else, everything is taken as standard. So let me say that I am going to create a 99. Yeah, standard comes with, yeah. Yeah, along with the software itself, it comes. Okay. So now what I am doing, like I am just creating a new organization. So I will say like, so it will say like, it will pop up. Since we are copying, it is taking all the data from the original one. So from which we are copying. Okay. So here you can overwrite it. So now I can see this one. If I save it, okay, it is going to be the myself organization. But as of now, I am not going to save. I just want you people to create your own organization. Okay, I just showed you where you can go and copy the sales organization. Now, as of company code, you don't create. I mean, like, this is the way you have to create the company code. But you don't create company code because that has so many assignments. So you always use the company code 1000. Okay, even though you create something. Yeah. Yeah, correct. Okay. So similarly, go for your distribution channel. The very same way. The distribution channel doesn't have any control. I mean, it is just a direct entry. You don't see any length button here, which means there is no detail. So you can just define a new entry. Once again, it is the okay, like Ambit. So this is the way you can define it. Okay. No. That won't be done automatically. You have to do that in the assignment part. Just now we are seeing the definition. Okay. So. Okay. Then you have the delivering plant. The storage location can be defined in the MM. Okay. So before defining the storage location, you have to define your plant. So go to the logistics execution. Why in logistics execution? Because we are going to execute the logistics activities here. Yeah. Yeah. Which one? Okay. Okay. This one. This is the documentation. If you have doubt what this node is all about, then you can click that and see. For example, if I click this, I can see what this node tells to me. Logistic documentation, logistic general, that is there. No, for definition, there is no document. For definition, there is no document. Okay, no documentation for that, yeah. Okay. So, you can... yeah. Okay. Your plant is defined in the logistics general because this is being used by all of your activities. So, your plant and the definition of your product. So, that is defined in the logistics general. So, you can go and see the plants here. For example, if my plant is 1000, so I select 1000 and I am seeing what are all the, one second.
Hello? Yeah. 10 minutes. Okay. Once you can see, it's not online. Yes, we can. Yeah. Okay. Okay.
Yeah. Okay, if you go inside the details of plant, you don't find much. Only the physical address is there. Okay. Similarly, for your division also, you can just, it's just a freely definable field. There is no control in this. So you can just 0304. Okay. You can choose, go through this and you can choose the number range which is not available. Okay. This system is being used by many people, so they have created their own using the code. So you go through that and you can create your own organization units here. Okay. As of now, no, we cannot, the number is, I mean, there cannot be any repetition. Yeah, restriction is there. For 2 digits, the divisions will be having 2 digits. Distribution channels will be having 2 digits. Your sales organizations will be having 4 digits. You can either use it alphanumeric or numeric. That is your choice. Okay. So here you go through that. Okay. So we'll see this customizing. I mean, like here you are defining the things. Okay. And you, whatever you have created, now go to the assignment mode, click that, okay, sales and distribution, can you see assign sales organization to company code. If I click that, sales organization is grayed out and I have choice to choose only one company code, because the assignment between sales organization and company code is unique. One sales organization can have only one company code, but one company code can have more than one sales organization. If you see this, sales organization 1000, 1020 and 1030, they have the same company code 1000. Okay. I go here. If I want to rewrite anything, So let me say instead of 1000, I want to rewrite to some other company code. Let me say 3000. Just do that. Okay. I don't want to save this. Similarly for your distribution channel and sales organization. So this is a multiple assignment. So you, there is no hard coding like that. If you click, you can get the sales organization and distribution channel. It means more than one, so you can have more than 1000. Okay. I can enter anything. 01, 02. 02 are already defined by somebody else, so I'm just using them. Okay. So this is how I assign the sales organization to distribution channel. Okay. And here we assign the divisions to sales organizations also. Similarly, let me say 1000. So let me, somebody must have created 9192. I just press enter. It is taking up. Okay, this is how you have to create and assign your enterprise unit. So before you start creating your own company code, your own sales organizations, distribution channels, I suggest you put it down a simple structure in the, your paper, saying that this is what my sales organization is going to be, and I, this many distribution channels I want to have, and these are all going to be my product divisions, and what I want to link. For example, your company might want to sell a particular product only through online, not through your regular agency division or your direct sales. In such cases, you have to assign them only to your particular distribution channels. Okay. Okay. Yeah, you can use that. If you remember that the distribution channel is just another number. It doesn't have any control in that. So you can use the same distribution channel in any of your implementations. Okay. If it is in different server, then you have to create new. Then you can use the same one.
Can you hear me now?
I can hear you.
One second. No? Hello? Can you hear me now? Yeah. Can you hear me now? Yeah. Okay, we are talking about this client naming and other things. So that is taken care by the basic people, and that process is called as landscaping.
Okay.
Okay. So right now let us go to where we are. So we have seen in the screen that what in this what are the things we have seen? That something called as company code, and we see next one as sales area. A sales area is a combination of sales organization, distribution channel, and division. And whatever transactions you do in the sales and distribution module, it is carried for a sales area only. So even though you have defined sales organization, sales officer, so whenever you create a sales transaction, it is going to be taken for a sales area only. Okay. So now you have to define what your sales area is. So let us go to the IMG, set up sales area. Here I am giving my sales organization, distribution channel, and division which I have created. For example, let me say like I have created a sales organization 1000, my distribution channel is 10, and my division is G1. 1000, again I want to use the same distribution channel but different division G2. Now let me say I want to use this sales organization and different distribution channel as well and division. Okay. I have to just enter the all the values here. Okay, enter the same here. So this is how you set the sales area. Okay. Hello? Yeah, okay. So till now what we have seen? We had created our sales organization distribution channel and division separately. Now I am combining together to form a sales area.
Okay. Okay.
First, my first column is sales organization. The second column is distribution channel, and third column is division. So I press new entry. I link all my newly created organization units and set up as a single sales area.
Okay.
Okay, this is what I did in this particular slide. So, SB consultant, you have to do.
Yes.
Okay.
And we get information from business?
We have to, yeah, obviously.
Okay.
We have to take information from the business, and since we had seen that setting up a sales area is subdoing on your previously created unit, so the more number of units you see, the more number of sales areas you will get. Which means your business is going to get complicated. So you must always maintain the sales area in a minimal manner. So try to reduce the number of distribution channels and divisions as much as possible. Okay. Yeah, yeah. Very nice. Birds?
Yeah.
No. Okay. So we will see the other assignments like sales office to sales area and sales group to sales office at a later time. Then we will see the sales organization, distribution channel and client.
Okay. Okay. So
first
when you create a sales area, you didn't
use the name for sales. No, there is no name. There is no name for sales area.
No name for it.
Yeah, this is just a link here.
Okay.
Similarly, when you have created a plan and you have to assign the plan to the sales organization and distribution channel combination. For example, let me say that I am going to assign this plan for me, let me say 1000 is going to be my plan, sorry, 10 for location, 10 is going to be my distribution channel. For this I am going to assign the plan to 100. No, it's a plant is not division related. I mean like you can I mean what to say. No, plant doesn't take if not you cannot assign the plant for a single division because in the particular plant you are going to handle products of many divisions.
Okay.
So that is the reason the division is not included in the plant assignment. For plants, you can have assigned only same organization distribution channel. For that, you assign a corresponding plant. Okay. So, just can Abhi, can you sum up what we have seen till now?
And
then, okay. Mm-hmm.
You will create your self-organization.
Okay.
Then your division and division channel.
Correct.
Then you will assign that.
A couple of things more. One more thing you have.
Company code.
These are the plants here. Go to definition. Okay. Definition, large is general. These are the plants here. Plant and division will be taken from large is general. This unit, large is general folder. Okay. So you have to define the plant. Hmm. In case of financial account only. Then organization.
It's possible.
So once you have defined everything, you go to assignment, you assign the appropriate unit.
Okay.
Now after distribution channel comes the division.
So, one distribution channel can have multiple sales organizations.
And one sales organization can have multiple distribution channels. Division first assigned to the sales organization. If you go to the assignment, sales and distribution, you can see assigned division to sales organization.
Okay.
Division, yeah. And before, I mean, like, before attending to distribution channel, you must say that these divisions are for these sales organizations.
Okay, yeah.
So you have to tell them, then only you have to attend to the distribution channel.
Okay.
Then we set up a sales area by the combination of sales organization, distribution channel and division. Distribution channel and division. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Okay, let's wind up with today's class here. I will send you the assignments for organization structure. Go through them, do them, and then catch up on Monday.
Okay, so Monday we are meeting
Monday at 9,
right?
Yeah.
And you are setting up the recording
presentation at 9. I'll try to upload the recording. I'll try. Okay. And I will send you the assignments now. Now it's done.
So,
what is the size of this recording? It will come close to 50 MB.
How much?
50, 50. Yeah.
Okay. If you
can
email us by you,
you send it. No, here uploading is a problem in India. In India, uploading is a problem. No, that. Yeah, yeah, I know that. Okay, let me try that, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I know that. Okay, I'll try that.